Ida B. Wells is a famed pioneering black journalist who actively reported on lynchings and violence against African Americans, for which she was posthumously awarded the Pulitzer Prize in 2020. Earlier this month, Wells received another honor when the Mattel toy company released the Ida B. Wells Barbie. The doll is all part of their Inspiring Women series. And joining me now are Ida B. Wells' great-granddaughter and great-grandson to tell us what it means to them. Michelle Duster, an author and public historian, and Dan Duster, a financial advisor and motivational speaker. Welcome.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you.
No, absolutely. Thank you guys for joining us. Now, this is such a great honor. I mean, for you guys, this has also got to be such a great honor to be able to carry on her legacy in such a ways that even it'll impact younger generations.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, Barbie has a long history of creating toys that teach and inspire young girls. And so to have Ida B. Wells introduced to that new generation in a fun and innovative way is incredible.
Absolutely. So it goes on sale Martin Luther King Jr. Day. So there's a lot of points to the doll that we actually have one here that was sent to us as well. There's so much to this doll, from what she was wearing to what she's holding and everything else, that just plays a major role even to when the date that she was released, the doll was released. Talk to us about the role that you guys played to get this final product.
Yeah, so Mattel reached out to us last year to receive our input on the doll, which, you know, it's was fun and interesting and exciting for me. I've never played with dolls, so to go through that process was an experience. But yeah, I mean, we gave input as to the features of the doll, the, you know, having a broad nose, the body shape. Mm-hmm. Michelle did research on, you know, that period of history to talk about the newspaper, what a printing press would look like. So we were very involved. We appreciate them extending that offer to us.
That has got to be so welcoming. So talk to us about the black dress that she is seen wearing. Like you had mentioned, the newspaper that she is holding. What is the significance of everything we see here?
Well, there was a woman, an artist, Patricia Wetwood, who created a portrait of Ida B. Wells, and the people at Mattel did a lot of research on the dress at that time, the way that women dressed at that time, and were inspired by that painting. But also, I mean, Memphis Free Speech was the newspaper that Ida B. Wells co-owned, and so that was a very significant part of her journalism journey, and where she started her activism when it came to anti-lynching crusade and expose the realities around lynching and domestic terrorism in that newspaper.
And now she also holds such a historic part here in our history in Chicago, even to this day, having streets named after her. I understand there's also a mural. What can people now see nowadays? I mean, if they can't get their hands on one of the dolls, there's also a lot of different ways around, especially our Chicago area, where she is being honored. Can you guys talk to us about that?
Sure. Well, as you mentioned, the Congress Parkway being renamed after Ida B. Wells, well, specifically from Grant Park to the post office, which is, I think, one of Chicago's, if not Chicago's, busiest thoroughfare. Mm-hmm. So that happened a few years ago. We worked on the monument, which is pretty much dead center where the Ida B. Wells homes used to be, as you see there, at 37th and Langley. And that was commissioned by Richard Hunt, who's an internationally known African-American artist. And our family has known him for years, and it's one of those things where I didn't fully appreciate how awesome he is until he took on this project. But yeah, he's internationally known, and this is one of the largest monuments for women in the U.S.
Wow.
So, and Michelle's worked on a couple other things that she can talk about.
Right. Yeah, I recently was involved in having a suffrage mural created at Harrison and Wabash that highlights 10 different local suffragists, and Ida B. Wells is one of those 10. Three of them are African American, so it shows the diversity that was involved in the suffrage movement.
Mm-hmm. That is amazing. And now, what is the message that you guys are hoping something like this, from having a Barbie doll after her, or even some of the streets here in our area here in Chicago, what is that message that you guys are hoping younger generations can take from something like this?
So I say broadly, just the fact that people of color and women of color have contributed enormous amounts of things to our society. And it's good to have her be recognized as well as other women of color. So that's one of the main things, is knowing that it's normal for anybody that has contributed to be recognized. Secondly, is providing courage and inspiration. Again, one of the things that Ida B. Wells is known for is her courage, is that she battled racism, sexism, and a lot of other isms during her time frame, and literally had her life threatened and had the courage to still stand up for it. So when I experience problems right now, I'm like, okay, this doesn't compare to what Ida went through. So let me borrow that courage and accomplish things like she did as well.
And now, even in your guys' roles in today's day and age, you guys still hold a lot of, like you had mentioned, you know, it's not what you might be going through is not exactly what she went through. But I feel like, and correct me if I'm wrong, I feel like that serves as a motivation for you guys in your everyday lives. What are you hoping that the general public, the general person who is watching this interview or reads this story or may come across the series that Mattel is releasing, what are you guys hoping that they can get out of it?
Well, my hope is that people can get out the idea that one person can make a difference, and the truth can be used as a weapon to combat oppression. And that's what Ida B. Wells was all about. She told the truth in order to highlight the false narratives that were pervasive during her time in order to affect change.
Absolutely. Well, you guys, thank you so much for joining me. We are going to put your websites here if they want more information. We have mldwriters.com and danduster.com as well if they want more information on you guys or just the work that you continue to do every day for us. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. It is an honor. Thanks.